Guys, I'm trying as hard as I can to give my $100 away. I'm trying. I did. I said Ronzi Contreras yesterday, I'd give you $100 if he didn't get 5Ks. The guy went out there and got 5Ks. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do the same thing again. I'm about to tell you about one bet that if it loses, I will give one YouTube subscriber $100. All you got to do is be a subscriber, obviously. Comment on this video, like the video, and you're all set. Before we can get to that, let's talk about the sweep we had yesterday. First off, Ronzi Contreras. That was the $100 play, and it hit so easily, it wasn't even funny. Actually, it wasn't that easy. He only got the 5 strikeouts, but guess what? All you gotta do is get the 5. If it's over 4.5, just get 5, you win. Everybody knows that. He had a no-no going for like 6 innings. Did not get that. I wish he would've got it, because it's always fun to have an over in the strikeout prop when a guy throws a no-no. That's just fun. But it didn't happen. The other one, Logan Gilbert, over 5.5 strikeouts. He got 6, which is awesome because 6 is more than 5.5. So that means we won that one as well. It was raining. I was kind of scared because sometimes when you take an over and the game, it starts raining, you get in trouble because they'll like stop the game. It gets delayed, whatever. Sometimes it gets postponed. Now you had your over, but it doesn't count because they postpone the game. It gets played the next day. So that always stinks. We definitely got to watch weather for that. But to be honest with you, who knows with the weather? You can't really predict that kind of thing. So it is what it is. We avoided a disaster there. We got the win. That's all that really matters. Finally, Michael Lorenzen. I think that might have been the greatest play of all time. What we're looking for when we gamble, or at least for me, I want to be entertained. I don't want to have a guy show up, strike out the first 6 guys. Now what am I doing? I mean, I'm not going to watch the rest of that baseball game. It's a baseball game. Like, who watches that? So you want a guy that kind of, you know, walks the high wire for you. Guess what? Lorenzen walked the high wire. The guy threw like 30 pitches in the first inning. Everyone saw it. He was terrible. He was giving up runs left and right. Like, we didn't even know if he was getting out of the first. But like a true champion, a man of the people, a guy who values our entertainment dollars, he buckled down and struck out 2 guys in the second inning en route to 5 for the game. He almost got to 6. If you watch my TikTok challenge, we wanted him for 6 in that. He almost got there. He actually should have got there. He had 2 strikes on like 15 guys, but just didn't get home. It is what it is. We're happy they cashed the big money one. That put us 3-0, and it lines us up for today. For today, guess what we're doing? I said yesterday it's awesome that we have day games. I looked through the night games, and I can't find anything. All I have is 3 day games, so open up your sports books now. Get ready, because you got to put these bets in immediately, because these games start at like lunchtime. That's bad, but also good, because we're going to have action at lunchtime, so there is that. The other thing is, they're not plus money. I went through again. Look, guys, I'm trying here. I can't find plus money bangers. The books are way too good in April for this, so I went minus money again. It worked yesterday. It's going to work again. I'm going to tell you what my grandfather told me when I was 8. He said, John, don't worry about the price. Just win your bets. That's as true now as it was back then, probably. First bet, first game of the day, we got both pitchers. Both pitchers, guys. 2-for-1. Usually gotta pay double for that kind of action, but not here. Kyle Wright, over 4.5 Ks, minus 152. That's disgusting. It's kind of better at other places, the price, but I tried at Barstool, I tried at DraftKings. They said, no, I can't bet $100. It is what it is. So I had to take the minus 152. It's not much higher at FanDuel than it is over at these other books. So there is that. But you could definitely get a better price than this. The Marlins strike out against righties. That's just what they do. Some people like to play instruments. Some people like to shoot basketballs. The Marlins like to strike out against righties. That's what they're into. There's at least 5 of these guys that strike out 31% of the time that could be in the lineup. There's another 4 that strike out at least 25% of the time. The only one we're scared of is Luis Arraez. He never strikes out. Like, when he comes up, you don't even have to watch the game because you know he's not going to strike out. But other than him, we're talking about 8 guys. Now, Kyle Wright really hasn't done much strikeout-wise this season. He's only been over this number once, but it was when he got 6. Last time out, he got to throw 95 pitches, didn't get home. It was against the Reds, which is kind of concerning. But again, this is the Marlins we're talking about here. 5 strikeouts should not be very hard. I think he gets it. And to be honest with you, the price tag really should be higher. I think this should be 5.5. That's just what I think. The next bet, this is the most manageable one of the day. Braxton Garrett, over 4.5 strikeouts, minus 130 at FanDuel. That's not that bad. That's a decent price, although I get sick when I see minus 130. But still, when you see a 4.5 attached to it, you're like, okay, well, I'll do that. Against lefties this season, the Braves just strike out. That's just what they do. There's five of them that strike out at least 30% of the time, and there's another four of them that are 22%+ of the time. I'm not really scared of any of these guys other than Acuna. He really doesn't strike out that much, and he will most likely be in the lineup. But still, five strikeouts, not that much, especially for Braxton Garrett. Here's the thing with Braxton Garrett. I think he's an undercover strikeout guy. I don't know that he's ever going to be like getting 12 in a game, stuff like that. But getting five is not that hard for him. He's done that twice already this season. Both games were against teams that don't really strike out that much. Even though one was against the Mets and they are definitely striking out a lot lately. I don't know what's going on there. But the Diamondbacks really don't strike out that much and he got five of them. In fact, he's only pitched against the Mets, Diamondbacks, and Cleveland this season, and none of those teams really profile as teams that I like to target just because they don't strike out enough. There's not a bunch of guys in that roster that strike out. There's a couple, but not enough to warrant a play, especially a minus 130 play. That's not true with the Braves. I just told you all the guys that can strike out. Braxton Garrett has thrown 80-plus pitches in his last three starts, so I would think that he's pretty much on a full workload at this point. He could go 90-plus pitches. If he does that, he's going to strike out five of these guys. This one should happen easily. But it's not the easiest play we have today. The easiest play today, the one that I will give one YouTube subscriber, one, $100 if this loses. All you got to do is comment and like this video and be subscribed to the channel because that's how you're a YouTube subscriber. Matt Strahm, over 5.5 strikeouts. It's in the minus 150s. Again, I tried to get a lower price somewhere else. They wouldn't let me bet $100, so I left. That's what you do when that happens. Look, this guy's a strikeout guy. He's gone over this number in three straight starts. But here's the thing. There was only one of those starts where he was allowed to throw 80-plus pitches. The guy was a reliever, so they had to stretch him out. It takes time to do that. Usually you'll see like he'll throw 40 pitches, and the next time he throws 60 pitches, then the next time 80. Well, he's 80-plus now. Guess what happened when they let him throw 80-plus pitches? He struck out 11 Colorado Rockies. I know it's the Colorado Rockies, but it is what it is. Still, 11 guys is super impressive, especially when you only throw 80-something pitches. Today, he gets the Seattle Mariners, and they strike out against lefties, guys. They do. I didn't make this up. There's like five of them that strike out 33%+ of the time. There's another four of them that strike out 25%+ of the time. There's not one guy in this lineup that I'm afraid of. Like, I'll watch every at-bat just because every single one of them could strike out. He could go double digits again, so I will say this. If you're at FanDuel, look at 7+, look at 8+, look at 9+, look at 10+, look at 11+. These are wild, wild prices, especially on like the 10 and 11, but it's not that crazy to think he could do this. The kid's at home. Again, he's got the Mariners. They're going to let him throw 80-plus pitches. I don't think the books have this guy priced correctly at all just because he hasn't really thrown a starter's workload yet. But he's still mowing people down like it's his job. It kind of is. This is probably the best bet of the day. Again, if you're looking for something plus money, that's probably the way to go on this kid. I wouldn't do the other two guys like that. They're probably just going to get to five, maybe six. This guy has the big time upside. All right, that's going to do it for the MLB picks today. The picks aren't done yet, though. There's still the TikTok challenge. I know it's been rough. It's a $20 to 20K challenge, and I'm down to 16 bucks. Yeah, so I've already lost $4. Here's the thing, though. Smart gamblers never give up. Ever. Ever, ever. You can never win your money back if you quit. Everyone knows that. That's science. And again, go back to what my grandfather said. Just win your bets. That's what I'm going to do today. I haven't figured out how I'm going to do it yet, but I'm just going to choke up on the bat, put a ball in play. That's all I'm looking to do today. All right, so that's coming up later. Follow me on TikTok. My handle's right on the screen, so it's pretty easy to see. I'll see you tomorrow.